Okay, hello, 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 welcome. Hey, I'm just using this as a metronome right now. And this today is a 1982 G&L. G&L is a Leo Fender guitar. And this is an S500. And it is made in California. Wow, that's hard to read, isn't it? Okay, but anyway, this guitar, I'm determined to get this in here. Will we see it? Will we see it? Well, I'll have to tell you what that says later, because I can't see it. But it's a, I was going to say Corona, California, but it looks like Palomino or something. Anyway, so what this is it's a 1982 Leo Fender guitar. It's a G&L. The L stands for Leo Fender. The G is a partner that he hooked up with. And you have to remember that the Fender company was sold, I believe, in 1965 to CBS. And I think it took until probably the 80s until Leo Fender kind of got back into creating the Stratocaster. This guitar, this G&L, was after a long period of time of not putting out anything from Leo. It's got a maple neck with the stripe. The stripe tells you that it's an early 80s model. And it doesn't have a switch on it. It's got a 5 switch. It's got 2 tone controls that work on all pickups. And these are like Telecaster, these rounded metal Telecaster tone knobs and volume knobs. The neck, again, to me, it looks like ebony, but from what I've read, it's rosewood. So rosewood and maple, or look at it. It looks maple. It looks ebony to me. It's got pearl inlay, metal pick guard. The pickups are called MFD, magnetic field design. And what's interesting is you can see they're kind of square. You see how they're squared? They're passive pickups, and they're single coil. But they get a different sound from the Seymour Duncan pickups, for sure. Here's the back of it. There's a 3-bolt neck. And again, this one is, I put the wood on this, in this, to block it. I don't use the tremolo on this guitar. There's a Spider-Man logo. I guess that probably will affect the value, perhaps. Or who knows? But I'm not going to sell it. Okay, it's got the contour body, again, the 3-bolt neck, and it's got the micro tuner thing, like down here. You can see that hole right about there at the bottom. That is for like a micro tilt tuning when you're doing the intonation. Again, 5-position switch. When I got this guitar, I was looking for a Strat, and been many years. People told me that I should get a pre-CBS Strat, and I couldn't find one. They were very expensive. Check out these tone controls. This is the 1st position. Thank you. first position. Fourth position. Position. Check out the Eternus tone down. Thank you. 1982 Fender G&L, and that is pretty much it. You can see it's starting to fade a bit. Can you see it? There's the lines. You can start to see these lines cracking. There was some people that talked about it cracking. But by and large, it's still... That's it, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you enjoyed that. Have a good night. Good night. Bye-bye.